specializes exclusively in making cask-conditioned ales. We'll be opening here, hopefully, in the next few months, looking at a May open date. And right now, we're looking at a brewery that is in a preliminary stage. So what happens is we heat up some water, and we transfer that water from a vessel that would sit here over into this vessel, which is called the mash tun. And this is where the water is brought up to a temperature usually between 148 and 156 degrees, and grain is added to that water. And over a period of about an hour, grain itself converts its own starches into sugars. Okay, that process is called mashing. At the point that that is done, that liquid is then transferred over into this last kettle, and more hot water is introduced into this, stirred around. That point is called a sparge, and that rinses all the rest of the sugar out of that grain. That goes into the boil kettle as well. This kettle is brought to a boil. At this point, this is called wort, and the wort has added to it, once it comes to a boil, hops. And there are a few different additions of hops, usually over a course of an hour, 4 hour boil, which is standard. And once the hour boil is completed, the wort is then transferred out of this through a cooling coil. It brings it down from 212 degrees down to what we call pitching temperature for the yeast. So that's usually, we start around 62 degrees Fahrenheit. So at 62 degrees, it comes out of the cooling system and then goes into a fermentation tank. This is a two-barrel conical fermenter. It's a 79-gallon vessel. We'll be making about 62, 63 gallons of beer at a time in it. Once it's brought into this vessel, you pitch yeast. The yeast is the substrate or the organism that actually will convert the sugars in that work into alcohol, and they also have a byproduct of carbon dioxide. This is the CO2 obviously escapes out of this fermenter. It's open to the environment right here, or an atmosphere as they say, through a blow-off tube. So what happens, this is actually flat beer once it's completed. A normal process is, for most breweries, is that beer is then artificially carbonated in CO2. At this brewery, we do a secondary fermentation in another vessel, and that's called a cask. So it's a little bit different than a keg because it's not used just to serve the beer, but it also ferments a second time in a cask. This vessel, not very exciting. You might think of the word cask and think of wood. It's not necessarily a wood vessel. Actually, wood is not ideal at all for doing this process because it lets too much oxygen into the cask. In this case, it's a plastic cask of 10.8 gallon, and that's known as a firkin. So if you've ever heard the term firkin, this is genuinely a firkin. There's one size smaller than this, it's half size, it's called a pin, but we will be serving out of firkins at Laxton Hollow. We're selling firkins, rather. So this is then tapped after anywhere between 3 and 5 weeks, okay? So it's going to condition in here. It'll be transferred over to the cooler of whoever's going to sell it, and they will use something called a beer engine.